What's up guys, it's the Dragon, back today with another video. In today's video, I'm going to be showing you how you can trade US30 and gold profitably. And I'm going to be showing you a bunch of the differences between these and all the other currency pairs. So gold and US30 are two of the most popular currency pairs. However, for some, they're incredibly difficult to trade. And I'm going to show you exactly why that is, how you can get around all of the different things which might cause you to be stopped out of trades, and exactly how I trade. So without too much talking, I've got a new Telegram, guys, so make sure you subscribe to it. Link in the description. Let's get onto it. All right, guys, the first difference between gold and US30, and basically every other Forex pair you guys are going to trade, is that these two are not Forex pairs, right? So every other Forex pair is a currency in another currency. However, XAU USD, gold is not a currency, it's an asset. And that's why this trades differently to Forex. Same with the US30, it's not even any sort of currency or asset, it's literally just the stock market. And for that reason, these two currency pairs, so-called, trade completely different to the rest of Forex. So now here is the number one thing which is completely different, which you guys are gonna have to watch out for. Number one, market structure matters. So when you guys are trading Forex, you're probably used to mostly checking out where the levels are, and then that's the most important thing on your chart, right? So you'll be looking for the fib zones, you'll be looking for levels like these. But when it comes to gold and US30, market structure matters. And what I mean by that is the direction of the market. So Forex itself is mean regressive. What that means is that it will tend to always return to at least some general mean point of where the prices fluctuate between. So here's an example right here. So if we look over the past of EURUSD, nearly every point at which the price has touched has been crossed many, many multiple times, right? So if I put my mouse here and we look at this level right here, it's been crossed so many times over multiple months. If we do the same up here, we just have to scroll back a little bit. It's been crossed many, many times over multiple months. The only times where this is an exception is where the price has made extreme highs and extreme lows such as here. And even this extreme high goes on to get touched again. So most Forex pairs are mean regressing and do not trend as strongly. And even if they do trend, you never know exactly when that trend is gonna turn around. Now, the difference between this and US30 and gold is gold and US30 trend incredibly strongly, and it's completely different to Forex. Now, don't get me wrong, all markets display some level of mean regression. However, you're gonna notice that on XAU USD gold, it's a lot less. So take, for example, this trending area right here. The price moves up. If I put my mouse at any one level, the price is not returning many, many times, right? So it's coming here, it's moving sideways for a little bit, and then it breaks out, and then it's properly trending, right? Here we had this huge dip which came back to touch this, but other than that, the price just continued trending. The market structure matters. Now, I hope you guys know how to analyze market structure. Basically, market structure is whether your market is in an uptrend or a downtrend. So if we're seeing multiple higher highs and multiple higher lows, with this right here being a higher low, and this right here being a higher high, higher low, higher high, that's essentially market structure. That's an uptrend. The other side, the other way around, is a downtrend. I hope you guys know that already. But what this strongly trending nature of both US30 and XAUUSD means is that when you are trading, it is much, much more imperative to only take trades in the direction of the trend. Now, I know people think this is true for all Forex pairs, but this is actually not the case. In fact, there are a few Forex pairs in which you actually want to trade directly against the direction of the trade if you want to end up with the best risk reward. Now, let's take gold in this period right here. So it makes a huge drop, and then it starts this small downtrend right here. Now, because of gold's impeccable market structure, we can, for example, take a trend line and draw it out from, say, here to here. And if I extend this, you can see that the price actually touched this trend line and it dropped immediately. Now, we know this wouldn't work for most Forex pairs. If I go on any other Forex pair, if you draw a trend line strategy and you just do a simple third touch strategy, a lot of times it will not work because the price will do fake breakouts. It may just straight up break out or do a fake breakout. It's very complex to do. However, when you understand that the gold itself trends incredibly strongly, you can actually use trend lines in order to find excellent buyers and sellers. So that is number one, and that applies to both gold and US30. Market structure in this currency pairs, or these two currency pairs, is incredibly important. Now, the second difference between gold and US30 and nearly every other currency pair is levels. So whereas most Forex currency pairs will do a lot of fluctuations around levels in attempts to stop everyone out, gold and US30 do a lot less of this. And what that means is you can actually accurately use levels in order to determine buyers. So we already went over this area right here, but what you can see is this is also a level, but I can guarantee you if I just look around right now, I'm gonna find other levels which you can take trades at. So you could take a small trade here. If I move this even further, you can take a small trade here. This is a massive difference between gold and any other Forex pair, is that you can literally actually use levels to make your buyers and sellers. Whereas if you solely use levels in Forex, you are going to get absolutely, absolutely destroyed. So when you guys are trading both US30 and XAUUSD, I really want you guys to make sure that you pay attention to these levels because they're far more important. If I just go into the US30 right now, I'm pretty sure I can find some similar examples. So I'll take this high right here, and we'll see what happens. So the next time the price comes in this range, we have a huge drop before it finally does break out over here. Let's see what else there is. These ones didn't really get respected all that hard, although this second time you can draw a range right here. So this range right here got respected. If I go on a little bit further, if you actually zoom out, you can actually see that this range got respected like almost a third time, because it broke through right here. Then every other time it touched this, it went up again. So you always want to watch out for levels when trading XAU USD or US30. This isn't to say you completely can't use levels for Forex trades. However, you want to be basically, you want to be more careful about them for Forex trades. But when you're trading with gold and US30, you can put slightly more weight on them as a confluence. And the final one I'm going to get onto, guys, is market patterns. So in Forex, we all know that market patterns basically don't work, right? So if you try to take like a bullish pull pattern trade, sometimes it will work out, but sometimes it won't. And it's enough of a ratio as to where you don't want to take those trades all the time, because basically you don't know which way it's going to go. There's so many different things which play into it, the trend, which other confluences are about, that becomes incredibly confusing to use them. And unless you're trading a very specific pattern in a very specific way, it's not going to be profitable for you a lot of the time. However, this is completely flipped with XAU USD and US30. These patterns work incredibly well. So I'm just going to take some examples right here. So we all know that if in Forex you see a standard flag pattern, it often won't play out. It's not to say it always won't play out, but it often won't. If we take, for example, in gold right here, we had the price descend, make a huge drop here, and then it started bouncing and basically made like a bear flag right here. We can see it played out very perfectly. Let me see if I can find more examples. Here we can see the price has had a huge descent. It makes a double bottom. It breaks out, and most intelligent traders would buy at the retest, which it does. And then if you bought at the retest, it goes on for massive profits. Now, it would be incredibly hard for me to find any examples like this in Forex, because once again, market patterns in Forex are a lot more difficult to rely on. It's not to say that you can't do it, it just means that you need to add in extra confluences in order for them to work properly. So you want to make sure, if you are trading Forex pairs, you're adding in way more confluences to check that your market pattern is going to work out. Whereas once again, in XAU USD, gold, or in US30, you can rely on these far more than any of the other currency pairs. Now, once again, guys, the reason for all these differences is that gold and US30 are really not currency pairs. I mean, gold is literally an asset. US30 is basically the stock market. And so keeping that in mind, you want to make sure you're trading them as such. They are different to Forex, so you want to make sure you're trading them slightly different to how you trade your other Forex pairs. So guys, that's been a quick video. I hope it was helpful. If it has been, make sure you join the Telegram, link in description, subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you guys in the next one. It's been the Dragon. Peace out.